Many people are aware of Britain's genocidal past and its role in colonizing the world. The extent of their awareness, I suppose, of Britain's crimes against humanity is a bit hazy due to decades of lies taught in schools or propaganda propelled by the media that many don't know exactly how egregious it is. And what's worse is that most people think it's something of the past. Most people don't know of Britain's role in today's wars. Till today, Britain plays a deadly role in attempting to either A, keep its hegemonic power, or B, ensure its allies across the world get to prop the governments that they want. Whether it's through the direct role in neocolonialism or its more insidious nature, the latter, make no mistake that the two are as deadly as one another. Now, the UK is directly responsible for its role in Yemen's humanitarian crisis. And I'm almost reluctant to call it a humanitarian crisis because the concept of humanitarian crisis can sometimes be brushed off as a result of a natural disaster or just pure bad luck. But make no mistake that when I say humanitarian crisis, I mean an implicit and direct result of Saudi Arabia's and UK's criminal role in Yemen. Now, when we look at what's happening in Yemen right now, we're talking about a staggering 20 million people facing famine, breakouts of cholera, typhoid, and now coronavirus. And what's happening is a deliberate attack. Saudi airstrikes with purpose and with intent have targeted Yemen's agriculture sector, its sewage system, civilian boats, schools, and most importantly, Yemen's medical facilities. And this is despite Saudi Arabia being made aware of the coordinates of the medical facilities. So any chance of any developing nation having to tackle coronavirus is already staggeringly difficult due to capitalism and loans, etc. But when you have a nation that deliberately attacks a very poor nation's medical facilities and then its agriculture system, so they can't even have food to survive, it becomes an impossible battle. And I know the recent statistics have come out about how many doctors have died due to coronavirus in Yemen, which makes it almost impossible to face. Now, I say that to say this, what's Britain's role in all of this? Saudi Arabia is Britain's biggest arms customer, and their relationship, therefore UK's role in the Yemen crisis, is umbilical. And I like the word umbilical because Loki described it as that, and I think it's really important to understand it's almost a paternal relationship rather than a business relationship. And that means any crime that Saudi Arabia is responsible for, Britain is also unequivocally responsible for. It is British companies which are responsible for selling arms. So I'm going to kind of list a few, so I might just look down on my phone for some statistics. But before I go on to the list, I want to make clear that everything that's taken place is completely against human rights law. For those who don't know, Protocol 1 Amendment of the Geneva Convention states that it's targeting civilians is a war crime and nothing short of it. So the British companies which have been responsible for the lives of Yemeni people being killed, one, BAE Systems. Now BAE Systems, for those who don't know, is a British multinational defense company that has been one of the primary beneficiaries to help Saudi Arabia's repression. Arms sold by BAE has been used by Saudi Arabia to do nothing short of providing anti-human repression across the Middle East, from its own citizens repressing its own citizens to fragmenting any calls to democracy in Bahrain. And they use BAE tactical armored vehicles, and now it's responsible for its catastrophic role in the Yemen crisis. Most notably in Yemen, BAE manufactured the Typhoon and the Tornado aircraft, which Saudi Arabia has used largely in its war. And I don't really like to call it a war because I'd see it more of an occupation, because a war describes a big fight back, which is not. But their contract was finalized in 2014, where about 72 Eurofighter Tycoon aircrafts were agreed at the cost of about 4.5 billion. And it is the UK that has directly licensed the export of 120 BAE-produced Tornado jets. And it's interesting because, you know, a lot of people like to propel Labour as this, like, party for the people, etc. But in 2006, when investigations were called to assess this really unjust relationship or this barbaric relationship as such. It was Tony Blair who cancelled it. And the senior judges at the time spoke about how this was completely unlawful. And it was also Nick Clegg at the time who said that the investigation was blocked to supposedly protect our security. Because at the time, Tony Blair said that there were threats of British lives being killed in the event of this investigation going through. But in fact, it looked increasingly like it was done to protect BAE sales by appeasing the Saudi government. And the party that's actually meant to be the opposition to the war hawk conservatives actually mirror their policies in every way alike. And these typhoons that we mentioned and fighter jets that Saudi Arabia has are being manufactured in Wharton, a British town. Two, BMDA. Matra Defense and BAE Dynamics have sold over 450 cruise missiles that has been manufactured right here in Hertfordshire. And on top of that, 100 Milan tank missiles. And Armament Research Service wrote a really good report about MBDA's guided missile bombs being used in heavily populated areas in Yemen. And again, this relationship that the UK has with Saudi Arabia is really important because each of these missiles go up for about £100,000. So these missiles and these precision guided bombs are also built in Stevenage. And then three, Raytheon, where Human Rights Watch have written about Raytheon's Paveway guided bombs. I'm sorry, I really struggle to announce some of the names of this because it's almost preposterous at how evil they sound sometimes. But anyway, Human Rights Watch wrote about the bombs being used in civilian populated areas. And Amnesty International itself has linked the Raytheon bombs with an attack on a ceramics factory. And a lot of this information is available on the CAT's website, which I implore everyone to read about. In spite of all the proof that the UK government had regarding Raytheon bombs being used the way they were, instead of stopping the arms sale, at the time they accelerated the delivery to at the request of Saudi Arabia and made a sense of urgency being called. So more profits, more quicker, at the expense of more Yemeni lives. And it came to the point that the Human Rights Watch document report written in 2016 included some of the details of the previously documented airstrikes on civilian economic structures. So there is clear, very, very clear evidence despite what Liz Truss says, that these weapons are killing innocent civilians. And these weapons are being manufactured right here. And the report also discusses how these strikes specifically target factories, warehouses, power stations, and a farm that at the time it killed 130 civilians. And the facilities hit by the airstrikes produced, stored, or distributed goods for the civilian populations, which included food, medicine, and electricity. Items that, even before the war in Yemen, were scarce and difficult to get a hold of. And now after the war has become almost impossible to a point where 2 million people are suffering from famine. So there has been this deliberate target of sectors that are pivotal for Yemeni survival that are being targeted. And the Raytheon Paveway guided bombs are built and manufactured in Harlow. And on top of that, more companies that play a part of Britain's insidious role in Yemen, such as Rolls-Royce, which don't only make cars, believe it or not, Lockheed Martin, Boeing, Hidden Technologies, and Leonardo. Again, all these weapons are manufactured in the UK and have been found in civilian areas in Yemen with UK markings. So the proof is irrefutable, to be honest. And make no mistake that the UK is completely aware of its crimes. Last year, after a Saudi airstrike killed 14 people in a potato factory, Boris Johnson recommended that Saudi Arabia should buy more British bomb parts. And then a day after his barbaric statement was recommended by Johnson, a village in Yemen was hit by another deadly strike by Saudi Arabia that killed 10 children. And at the time, Export Control Joint Unit had written an email on the 12th of August saying that Johnson was more than content to advise the licensing of these components so the Paveway bombs should go ahead. But not only that, more proof is written in government documents about how aware they have been about these attacks. So written evidence from the Foreign and Commonwealth Office has openly admitted to Storm Shadow missiles being used in Yemen. And it quotes, the UK has supplied the Saudi armed forces with a range of military aerospace and naval equipment and services that has included Tornado, Hawk, and Typhoon military aircrafts, naval mine hunters and weapons, and logistics support, training and infrastructure packages. Now, in the same document goes on to say that the United Kingdom and the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia enjoy a deep and long-standing history of friendship, cooperation, and this extends to areas such as education, healthcare, culture, energy, aid, and then defense and counter-terrorism, as well as the shared challenges facing the Middle East, which if anyone really knows beyond their relationship in the Middle East, it's nonsensical. Saudi Arabia has a history of funding Islamic fundamentalist groups across the Middle East. So this idea that this relationship is to protect the Britain from the insurgency of terrorists, it's preposterous. And this relationship is nothing if not mainly centered on the fact that this it's worth 4.7 billion in arms trade deals. So I just wanted to kind of reflect exactly of Britain's role before I pass it on to the next panelist on what they have been doing with Saudi Arabia and how Britain is directly responsible for its role in Yemen's crisis.